All right, so that's it. Yeah, welcome to day 262, Making Songbringer. I'm experimenting with having the chat open in a separate window today, so hopefully that's working for y'all. You finished Ori, right on. Cool, how was it? What's up, PvP Kaif? Can I pay to be put in the game? How do you want to be put in the game? And Parks and Rec, right on. Nice, productive weekend. Boogie, what's up, man? Oh. Gotta get everything hooked up. I'm trying something new today with the chat window open on my iPad. Loved it. Nice, right on. Hey guys, how does the chat look from your end? Like on the actual live stream, does the chat look cool? Akuma, what's up, man? What do you mean you borked your game? Wow, easily one of your top five games of all time? All the more reason I gotta play this. I was gonna play it this weekend, but I was really busy. There's a lot to do with this game. I am gonna play it though, pretty, I don't know when. But I'll have time at some point, I'm sure. You can't see the chat on the stream? Oh. That's weird. Yeah, it's showing it's not on here. But this shows it is if I do the preview. Weird. My preview window has your chat. Yeah, I'm trying to do an overlay window. I wonder what happened to it. Why did it do this? There's the chat. Do I gotta save it? Come on, chat. Some setting, maybe it's off. That's weird. It says it, even on this little window down here, it says, well, it looks like I might have to go back to the other, the old way. Oh well. What's this thing here? This is the audio volume of that window, I guess. Add a new layer. Yeah. Well, this should be a layer already. I mean, I think this is part of that layer, so I don't know. Well, oh, is it working now? Wait a minute. It might be working now. Might have to tweak it as far as maybe those. It looks like it is. All right, cool. Akuma, I loaded in the maps. Oh, damn, dude. That's one reason to get Git working, dude, right away. Before you ever do anything else in your project, start a Git repo. What's up, J2? Okay, I'm gonna tweak the chat window, so hopefully you can read it a little easier. I think people's messages could be white and it would be, is that easier to read? What about changing all the names? No, that's kind of weird. How's that look? Oh wow, crazy. With Ori. 7 hours? Whoa. Okay, all right. Oh, black background with some transparency? Sure. If it'll let me, let's see. Oh, there, yeah. Nice. Yeah, how's that? Maybe a little less font weight. Now a little more. I don't know. You guys tell me. Is it better now, J2? Boogie? Cool. All right, Akuma. Okay, all right, I'm gonna save this and get on to making the game. Better? All right, cool. Okay, yeah, let me know how that goes. I can always switch back to doing the old way where I had the window open on the left or whatever. But anyways, today's goal is to work on, I'm just gonna kind of like try and not have too much of an agenda today, but I really do just want to work on these gates. Oh, and also there's this new thing where the camera follows the player a little bit too. So you can see as I move around the screen, the camera follows the player a little bit. And I fixed all the transitions. There's so many bug fixes I did yesterday to get the transitions working better. The lights don't flicker. The transitions are really smooth now. So let me know your thoughts on the camera follow. I'm gonna leave it on for most of the stream today. I'm just gonna the camera's gonna follow the player a little bit. Put it on the right? Sure. Yeah. Is that good? How's that? Okay, so as far as this code goes, oh, let me show you where what the game does. I did some improvements as well to the overworld. Shorter, maybe? Sure. Yeah, no worries. Gotcha. Shorter chat it is. Oh, now it disappeared. Dang. Thing's kind of finicky. It didn't update for you. What do you mean? Oh, there, now it's working. Yeah, okay, it's working again. Huh, weird. All right. Too much fiddling. It's good now. Okay. H7, what's up, man? Are you coding your game with Apple Framework? No. But yes. I'm using Apple's frameworks, but only on iOS and Mac. Okay, cool. Yeah, I don't know what's up with that finicky part of it. So let me show you the overworld scene. This is what's there's a lot new here. know what I mean? So all the G's are places where there's gates. So the overworld on any one of these screens that has a G, it will actually put some gates to prevent the player from accessing what's right a screen over. Jonah19, what's up, man? High five. So yeah, let's take a screenshot of this. This world's called Wizara. And yeah, so basically all these areas with G's are places where it's going to gate off parts of the overworld. But so I'm on this screen right here next to level 1 when I run the game, and this area needs a bit of love. I'm thinking that basically the gates right now, the gates are put on every single area. Or I mean every single side of the screen gets a gate, and that's not how I really intended this to be. What I wanted is for the gates to only appear like to the left over here, because this is the only screen where it has, you know, it's supposed to be gated to get to that. So really there should only be a gate on the left side of the screen. So I'm gonna start working on the code for that. Trying out you know, how that looks, how that works, because I kind of like it, how it gates the whole everything, you know, it gates every single side of the screen. It's kind of nice, actually. But then when you get into areas like this, you start having gates over and over and over again, and so that's kind of not cool. So I want to try experimenting with only one gate per screen, or more if there, you know, if it needs more certain areas or whatever. All right, cool. Yeah, I don't know what's up with the lag today. Let me see if there's something on my end. Oh yeah. Yeah, it might be on my end. It looks like it did reset the stream just a second ago, or a minute ago. I don't know. It might be this chat window. Or might have something else going on. Experiments, this always happens when you experiment with stuff. But it does appear the game show is using a proper amount of CPU right now. That's good. All right, Akuma. Okay, so I'm gonna dive into this code and figure out how to put the gates only on one side of the screen. It's been okay since it restarted. All right. Good to know. Might have just been connected to Twitch all weird or something. Where was it that it placed the... Oh, yeah. So looking for just K flag gate. And oh yeah, here it adds key conditions for each one of the doors. All right, I'm gonna set a breakpoint here for the area that I'm currently on only. So if it's area 830, we'll set a breakpoint. Oh, we don't have area pause here. Well, this is world create maze int z p.x, p.y. Okay. Oh, sorry. If P, oops. If this area is position P, yeah. Whoops. Yeah, so I think it's right here. I think it's creating a key condition for every single one of these screens, but really it only needs it for one. All right, cool. We've got it. We've got a breakpoint here, and let's see what direction this is. This is direction 0. I should get this hit. Yeah, 1, 2, 3. This is the third direction. Let's figure out what number we're getting here. Num is flag number 4. So what I intended to do was basically there's 32 different flag numbers. There's going to be up to 8 different traversal type items in each world. Like some worlds will have different traversal items, so it'll be interesting that way. But that's 8 different traversal items, and that's 4 different directions per screen that a gate can be on or off. So basically that's, you know, I'm shifting down by 2 to take off the actual direction, and ending by, you know, the bottom 4 bits would give me the number of the direction. So this is number 4. Wait, let's see that all again. It might not have put on the directions actually yet. All right, so direction 0, we have number 4. Number 4 is just, we're missing the direction data. So something went wrong there. And if I do it again, it's just going to give me 4 again. Yeah, so direction 1, we still have 4. Yeah, all these are 4. Pretty sure. Let's check that. Okay, yeah, so it looks like I forgot to add on the direction data. And so where does it place the gate? Yeah, right here. So here, we need to check all these out where it's actually placing all the gates. Yeah, and that's kind of weird. This plus D right here should be adding it. Let's figure out what's up with that. And yeah, I'm gonna be right back. Is everything still working? Looks like the stream's up. All right, I'll be right back. BC Warrior. Oh, this is one downfall of having the chat window open like that. Oh, I guess I can type manually BC Warrior over here. This is like iPad version typing though. Yeah, I think I know what it is. I think it might be actually be setting these directions, but it's not reading them correctly. So this flag number, what's it come out to be? Flag num. These are okay to keep them. Flag number 3, which is, the level. What's level? Zero. Shift it up to right. How could this flag number be? Yeah, okay, that's right. Flag number 3. We're getting flag number 7, which is level 1 plus direction 3. Okay, I think this one is okay. I'm gonna disable that breakpoint for a moment. I believe it is this right here. It's getting the flag number, but that's wrong because that get flag number actually just gets one single number only, whatever is the first flag it can find. But the way these are working is you could have possibly have multiple different numbers attached to a screen. Like for example, a screen might have, a flag for the gate, but then it might have a north gate and a west gate or whatever. And each one of those gates could have different types. Yeah, so basically the flag number right here should be flags and just the top 32 bits, basically. Yeah. So we want the top 32 bits, and then the key condition is only if the bottom 3 bits, no, the bottom 2 bits. So if num and right, does that give me the bottom 2 bits? No, I think we need to do OX3. Let's get a, actually the num direction or whatever. So we'll call it dir on num and 03. Just because I can, ruined it. So if num and oh, if num dir equals d, then we have this key condition. I can set a breakpoint there to, let's disable this breakpoint for a moment and run it, see what happens. Yeah, no real harm. I expect it to kind of be a slow week. I mean, it's Thanksgiving week here in the States. Okay, so what screen is this? 83. Hey, that's the one we wanted to do anyway. Great. So screen 83, what's the num direction that it gets right here? or and then num as well. The flags, something huge. Let's view that as binary so we can clearly see. Yeah, so we've got blah, 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 top bits. It's only a few of them up there. Okay, so the num. Yeah, we've shifted off all those bits and we have only one. Damn, looks like it didn't pass in those bits. Oh, so zero is a direction. That's right. Huh. So that means to the south, but that's not right. Let's run this again. We got, this time we've got 10, 3, 0. The number is, once again, 0. Yeah, this isn't working. All these are 0 for the direction, which can't be. Okay, anyways, let's get back to this other bit of code. So, where was that? Here? No? Here, yeah. Okay, once again, I'm gonna turn on this breakpoint. And watch all the flag numbers that it's adding. Be cool to see this actually as binary though. Okay, let's watch this. Actually, yeah. Wait, no. Yeah, no, yeah, yeah. No, yeah, 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 no. Flood, what's up, buddy? How you doing, man? How's it going? I'm trying out a new chat today. WizJib's not working? Yeah, it's WizJib. Unless that's not working. Oh, wait. It should be working for you, yeah. Maybe it's working for you, but it's not working for me because I have my iPad open. I don't think my iPad can do Franker faces. Ah, so it's a good thing to experiment with all this, huh? Did that do it? I can't see. This is one thing that sucks about Oh yeah, it doesn't do it on here either. Oh, it works for you guys, but I don't know if it works for the stream though. So for you guys watching, I don't think it's gonna do those special emotes. Oh, you're starting a Patreon. You're wondering how to do it. All right. Interesting. What's up, Blood? I'm working on the gates in the overworld right now. Yeah, it doesn't work on the stream. Yep, because it doesn't have Franker faces. But, Blood, this is what I'm working on. This is the world generator version 8. It's even smarter now. Basically, what it's doing is it's placing gates So all these G's are gates that are supposed to block off like one direction that you can walk in. But right now they're blocking off all directions, and so I'm working on the code so I can make it so it only blocks one direction. Nice. You're working on Dungeon Generation 2, Boogie? Boogie. Okay, so it's setting the flag number. What flag number we got here? Oh, I wanted to see this break here, not there. Okay, so we've got flag number 3. That's level 0. Yeah, level 0 plus direction D3, south, west, east. What screen is this? Oh, this is 12-2. Okay, and after I shift it up, we should have flag number int 0. Oh, there's the problem. That's what it is. So this flag number is very important to be, a 64-bit int. See that again. You finished Axiom Verge? Nice. How'd you like it? Okay, this time we have flag number 3 once again. This time shifting it up though gives us a good value. There we go. That's probably the bug. Yeah, so we've got that bit, that one single bit shifted. No, there should be two bits. Should be a 1 and a 2. What? Yeah, so we've got 1-1 there. Oh, no, this is shifted up. This might actually need to be flag 1 plus. Yeah, it's flag 1 plus. Wild arcane appears. I'm gonna go ahead and attack. Yeah, nice. You loved it, other than the eye strain. Yeah, totally. Wow, 92% area discovery. That's pretty good. Boogie's running away. Gonna throw a wild cinder block at the arcane. It's a Pikachu. That movie was hilarious. You got, yeah. That was so hilarious. Or that one video. It's Pikachu. No. It's very effective. Arcane used a hey guys. What does that do? What happened? What's my status now? Oh, whoops. No, that's not right. This is flag. Basically, it's just flag one. Flag num shifted up 32. It's complicated. There we go. Okay, now we've got the proper bits shifted up to their proper positions and all that. And let's check a few more. Flag number for this is area 400, direction 3. Once again, Oh, so this one, what's this one's level? This one's level one. So, yeah, we've got 111 there. The triple one. Some more bits there. Why are these all direction three? Three, one. Okay, great. There's one that's not direction three. Yay, and that looks good too. Okay, I'm happy with this. Let's disable this breakpoint, go to the next breakpoint, and make sure that's working. And if so, we can try it out. We can run the game. It's not censoring your cursing. Even on the, okay, so it's on the display. Okay. Oh, yeah, it isn't. I wonder why that is. I mean, it should be just connected straight to, huh? Oh well. Good to know. Good to know. Okay, so I don't know. Maybe I'll stick with this whole chat overlay this way. It is kind of nice to just have my whole screen available for development. But yeah. But this is these are good things to know, to consider. Okay, we've got direction 83 or yeah, screen 830. This should have a direction to the west only. So we've got num and numdir. Num, shoot it down 32 is 1, 1. Okay. Numdir, this should be west, but it's not. Oh, it is. Oh, right. Okay, so this screen has two different 83, is that right? Wait, 0, 1, 2, 3. No, yeah, this should only be to the west. Man, what the heck happened here? Numdir equals D. D is 3. Yeah, I don't think this is working. But let's see what happened. Yeah, it does go on YouTube. Dodge Whale, what's up, man? Okay, so this completely broke them. There should be some a gate right here. There's no gate. No gate there. Oh, there's a gate here, though. That was proper. That should definitely have happened. Yeah, there's been camera shakes for a while. You mean the camera follow? Yeah, I'm experimenting with the camera follow right now. Yeah, once again, there should be a gate right here, but there's not. You know what? I think this just needs to be dir num, because that totally doesn't a mod. Or it could be num mod 4 is fine. Just to make it explicit. Nice. You like the camera following? Nice. Yeah, I'm really liking the camera follow too so far. There's a few things I need to like fix. Like for example, this screen's messed up now. There's a few other issues like that are simple things I can clean up. But other than that, I'm really liking camera follow. One thing I might want to do is actually clarify what side of the screen can be walked onto and off of. Like right now, you can't really, it's hard to detect that there's an area down here you can walk south from. And there's other areas like that too. With this camera follow, you're not quite seeing those edges of the screen. So maybe I'll add some like little fireflies or something like that to these top corners or whatever. But first I want to get the gates to work. There should be a gate right here. Oh, so you haven't seen enough of the camera follow to judge it. Yeah, okay. All right, well, I am going to release an updated alpha version with before December 10th for the Indy Cup. I'm going to update the alpha versions, submit it back up to Steam. So anybody that has access to the alpha version will be able to play it. So I'll be looking forward to your guys' comments then when you can play it and actually try out the camera follow. See how it actually goes, you know? I won't make any final decisions or whatever till after that. Yeah, maybe. Maybe. Yeah, it might need to be something that could be disabled. Okay, I'm going to do another breakpoint here with area. When you choose to disable it, it makes it more intense. Yeah, Arcane, exactly. What came to your mind was, if I'll be able to see all the exits. Yeah, that's why some of the exits I want to hide, right? This is supposed to be an exploration secret finding game in some ways, kind of like Metroid. But in some senses, you really do want to just see, hey, there's an exit over that way. And so maybe I'll add some little flying fireflies or something like that near every area or something. So to make it a little more clear, and then maybe not put the fireflies on secret exits or whatever. What's up, Speedy Flip? Troll options. Yes, I want to set the option to be trolled. So for anybody just joining the stream, I'm working on gates. These are just like things that allow or disallow the player from accessing a certain area unless they have a certain traversal item. The sword is the first traversal item. It allows you to get rid of grow back tiles, these like thorns that grow back once you cut them away. I'm adding little tiles like that to the overworld so that, for example, you need to have the sword to get to level 1 or bombs. That's it. It's not going to require the sword to actually beat this game. You can actually get away with playing the whole game without the sword. This is wrong. 830. This is 7, 8. 1, 2, 3. What? This is wrong. I think. P.x. Hold on. Dungeon entrance 2-5 at 8-3. Oh, this is not even the world. This is not even the world that... Yeah, okay. This is generating the world several different times here until it gets a world that satisfies all the checks and stuff like that. So this needs to be 9-3 in order for this to... Whoops, wait. This is world. Let me back at maze. Yeah, this one should be 9-3. Or just checking Q for 8-3. Okay, let's do this again. Yeah, Arcane, it's been real buffery and laggy today. I don't know what's up. Just a bomb pouch. Really? Yeah. Do they really have porn? How so? Good question. Good question. How is that not a stream? All right, so this is the right area. Flag number, the level. Level should be 0. Direction 3. Once again, this is the wrong direction. Okay, I see what's wrong there. This D needs to be the opposite direction. This is dir D plus 2. Yeah, better. Flag number this time. We've got level dir D plus 2. Flag num should be. South? No. Oh, wait. Yay! We've got west. Finally. We've got basically no. A 0 on the actual traversal item number, but a 1 on the direction. Oh, Kuma, yeah, for sure. It's a good idea. One challenge mode there already is permadeath mode. Right, half a heart hero. No health expansions and all you have is half a heart? That'd be really hard. Wow. Okay, let's see. Flag number shifted up. We still got 1. So yeah, that should work there. Now we're placing a gate at area 100. Where is that? 100. Yeah, 100. Yeah, right here. Good. So that should be placing a gate to the north. So num dir should be north. Num dir 2. Yes, it's north. This might be working now. Have I tried the Zelda 1 randomizer? No, I've never even heard of it. That's cool. Zelda 1 randomizer. I want to save this link, but I've got my chat window open somewhere else. And that didn't work either. Damn, what the hell? Zelda randomizer. Oh, cool. That's awesome. Interesting. I would like to play this. Thanks. By old Tom Tay. Sorry, I don't know how to say your name, but let me know. Let me know how to say your name if I can. Yeah. Okay. It should have put a door there, but it didn't. Or should have put a gate there, but it didn't. Oh, obviously. The key condition is the number shifted down 2. And in this case, we have a key number 0, or key condition 0. So this needs to be num shifted down to plus 1. Come on, work this time. Yeah, it's true, right? Yeah, the game's definitely coming to Steam. Yay, look at this. We finally have growback tiles in the right place. It gets you to this level. There should be some bombable tiles up here. No, wait, is there not? Damn, there's no bombable tiles right here. Boo. But there is there. Okay. I think there's another area of levels up here. Okay, these worked. Yay. Alright, so what happened to that other one? Right? It probably is. So this is level 5. Oh, you know what? It could have been because there's two gates on this one screen. Yeah, that's probably what it is. This is in world. Okay, so let's go to area 840. Enable breakpoints. Wait, oh, whoops. I want that one on, but this one off. The game is really spoopy. What's spoopy mean again? Sorry, I saw that on Super Positive's stream one time. But I guess I never really looked up what spoopy means. Right, good. We're at 840. Got the flag gate. Current direction is south. So num is coming out to be default 23. Spooky. Oh, cool. Nice. Yeah, some of the music is meant to be spooky. Some of it's meant to be sort of like light and airy. But since we're in sort of a darker area there. Yeah, badges. Yeah, I've seen those. Spoopy is so spooky you might poop yourself. Probably is that, right? You gotta love internet definitions. I think this might have been, I might have messed this up. This data, I'm not sure if this data can actually contain both directions. For example, you would have to have on bits one. Oh man, yeah, this doesn't work. Bits, yeah. For example, okay, so there's. This particular area right here. This gate with two levels, right? Accessible from the single gate. One of them is level two, which would be gate number. Level two would be gate number two, or gate type, traversal item number two. And then going to the west. Yeah, no, two to the east would be three or five. And then five, yeah, already it doesn't work. Oh man, I can't believe I messed this up. Yeah, totally. I've seen that. I've seen people selling them. Yeah, totally. Oh, I can't put two directions in one. Oh yeah, I can. All right. I got it. So right now it's putting in the actual traversal item number and putting in the direction. But really what needs to happen is the direction is 4 bits, but those 4 bits need to be shifted up based on the traversal item number. So if it's traversal item number 2, it would be shifted up 8 whole bits. Okay. We got this. Just gotta rework this code. I knew there was 32 bits, 8 directions, 4 bits per direction. I knew that would work somehow. I just like didn't do it right at first. Yeah, you might. Yeah, you can totally start a business around that. Okay, good. Here we are at Maze. There needs to be no level number built in. Take the opposite direction and shift that up. Two times the level number. So if we've got level number 0, that's just the direction. Level number 1 would be this shifted up 2. Level number 2 would be this shifted up 4. And then shift all that up 32 bits and add it. Yeah. Okay, this is much better. Much better. Let's enable that breakpoint. And go back to world. And this world needs to be processed differently now too. We're not only shifting down 32 bits, we also need to shift down for each one of the directions and numbers. Okay, first of all, let's see that other stuff in action. Pedro, what's up, man? Yeah, we're still having some twitches and or some lag. I don't know if you are, but some people still are definitely having lag issues today. I don't know what's up. What's up with Game Show? Game Show, oh, see, it's only been connected 25 minutes now. So yeah, something's wrong with Twitch again, where it's cutting me off their server every once in a while and dropping the stream, but apparently it should be reconnecting and everything. Interesting article on game trailers, huh? For the version 5. Cool. Nice. Let me check that out. Kama Sutra? Yeah. Oh, by the way, Pedro, I found that link that I was trying to share with you the other day. Let me save that for reading later. But here's the link to here it is. 3 things. I think we were talking about this, right? About marketing and this was Lime Studios, wasn't it? It was Lime Studios that was asking this, I think. But this was about that gamers don't like to be, players don't like development studios. They like developers. They don't like companies. Yeah, it was Lime Studios. Okay, I'll send that to him on Twitter or something like that. But I thought we were more discussing about something else. So yeah. Okay. Anyways. Okay, we're back here. Flag number, direction, shifted up 2 times levels. So level is 0. Direction, 3. It's going to come out to be 1. So this should all just turn out to be 1. Yeah, good. We got 1 there. But this is not being parsed correctly yet. Just want to see a few more directions for other areas. Wait. All right. This is 830. 4-0. Yeah, this is the one with two. So this is a very, very interesting one to check out. Flag number. This one we got 1-1, which would be three. Direction three given. Yeah, one plus two is three. So this is to the east. And yes, it's shifted up one. So that means it's level one. Good. All right. Yay. That worked. Yeah, rip. No, no, I'm not streaming to my iPad. Yeah, that's a good question. No, my iPad is only has my chat open. And yeah, I think this is it. It reconnected again, so we should be chatting. Just in case you guys didn't get that, or if it wasn't streaming at that point. Yeah, I'm just chatting on the iPad. I don't think... Yeah, I mean, I guess it could be on my end here. Who knows? Our internet could be messed up. All right. Yeah, every time it restarts my stream, it shows you guys an ad. Sorry about that. Yeah, uBlock for the win. Okay, this should be the same area. No, this one we're at 10-3. Yeah, here, 8-4-0. This time we should have direction is west, or D should be 3. Yeah, D is 3, good. And level is like 5 or something, so level 4, yeah. All right, starting from 0, good. This looks like it's setting these flags correctly now. Let's see what happens when I actually set the flag. Yeah, I can't really see it. Okay, I think it's parsing, it's now placing these gates correctly. Oh, Xbox. Game Boy Color. Oh, did I ever get to a point in the game where I wanted to redo the whole thing? Yeah. No, I haven't. I haven't been to that point yet. Yeah, I don't know. I'm really, really stoked about this game. I have never really wanted to change it. I've loved it from day one, and I still love it. Yeah, okay, so now we need to parse it. We need to loop over every single one of the possible gates or traversal items this could possibly be. And then yeah, okay, so loop over. Loop over all the gates. Oh no. South. Oh, I forgot about south being 0. How the hell am I supposed to distinguish? Oh man. Oh. If all the 32 bits were zeros. It's the same thing as saying south is enabled for every one of those directions. Damn it. Can't believe this whole stream I've just been working on this one little thing. Ugh. Yes, modded Ataris. You need motivation for continuing, Pierre. You don't know where to get it. Why'd you start it? What was it that caused you to start wanting to make Pierre? You're watching using ARPANET? You can't. You definitely cannot get more cool than that. Damn. So basically, either. Every direction needs 5 bits instead of four, which would mean that there's a total of six traversal items only. Or I can set it so every gate. I could just do smart gates. So every gate area. You would just be smart and it would know that, oh, I need to gate off this area to the west because it's going. No, but that wouldn't work because. I guess I could give four directions into the lower bits. Oh, right. It might have been the stream lag, I don't know. Well, yeah, so once again, why did you start making Pierre? I mean, what was your motivation to start with, you know? Oh yeah, like Akuma just mentioned there. Money and hoes, man, that's all you need. What else do you need? Nothing. All right, I could put four different flags into, like, I could put a north, west, east, and south flag. I mean, I guess I could just use that as same kind of concept for. Yeah, why the hell not? Why not just put the directions like this? So, flag 29 is north or south. West, east, and then I could have all the traversal item numbers 1 through 8. Those are all separate bits, and then these are all separate bits. Yeah, why the hell? Okay, yeah, that'll work. Creative boredom. Cool questions, Akuma. I like where you're going with this, man. Okay. So you wanted to see if you could implement those mechanisms. Now you're at the point where you've implemented those mechanisms. Naturally, your motivation is gone. Maybe you need to find some other source of motivation. Maybe you need a different challenge, like maybe you need a different challenge, like, okay, let's see if I can finish this project or something. Or maybe you just don't want to. Maybe it truly is the where, you know, I don't know. Man, I don't know if I'm even helping at all with this one. Yeah. Make them more better than wow alone in 4 weeks with only one hand. You gotta hunt and peck the whole time. Okay, I think I'm gonna make the first 4 bits the direction, and then the next 8 bits the flag number or the traversal item number. So that's gonna be the direction shifted up. Nothing. This is going to be level plus one. No, not level plus one, just level shifted up two. Okay, once again, here we are redoing it. But I think this is right now. There's enough bit. There's 32 freaking bits, man. There's got to be enough room. Learn C++ in 21 days. Engine programmer, yeah. I could do that with my leg. All right, what area is this? This is area 13-2, level 0. And I do want to see this flag number like that there. Oh wow, cool. iPad chat, you can just open up window. Oh, nice. Dude, nice. Ray tracer, man. Looks beautiful. Yeah, really awesome, blood. This should be one. Flag number one. Adding in the level, which is level 0. Want to see a level, another level. Let's just write the code. World. So we're going to get all those flags up there. The direction is mod 4. Oh my god, this is actually fine. Number equals. Let's enable that one, delete that one. Really? Whoa, once a year? Wow. Yeah, Vlad already is the boss, though. Maybe you need like a personal trainer for your hobby time. You need like somebody to tell you what to do for your all your hobby development. Look at this. There's a lot of ones in here. Oh, that's because the flag numbers has already getting flag number direction. Oh, this is here. Yeah. 840. This should be a confusing one because we should have a few different things. So flags should not do. We get num. Here we go. Num. What are you, num? Zero. Straight up zero all across the board. No flags. No, did that wrong. Right? Wait. Yeah, there should be a direction here. There's no direction at all coming through. Damn. What the hell? Yeah. Yeah, J2, the only way I could be clearing it, that's a good question. I could be clearing it if I'm resetting it anywhere. But really I'm using OR whenever I do sets to the flags. So this should be OR'd. Let's make sure of that. Yeah, every time I'm setting a flag, I'm just OR'ing it. So there's really no way to unset the flags unless I clear them manually, but yeah, I don't think. Yeah, K flag gate is a 64-bit value. Good question. Very good question there too, J2. But yeah, all these are all guaranteed to be 64 bits. Both of those, yeah. It needed this LL for that to work, but yeah. Good question. Okay, so this is, once again, we're at area 840, which should have a gate to the left and a gate to the right, or that's west and east. All right, here we are. We're about to set the flag for direction 1, which is west. So flag number turns out, this is actually to the east, which would be. So flag number should be 3 to start with. Yeah, we've got 3 there. And then we're anding equals level shifted up 2, which is. I think this actually needs to be level plus 1. Yeah, that needs to be level plus 1. But still, that flag should have come through. there's the problem right there. Okay, so yeah, J2, thanks for putting me on that track, J2, to check those, because you totally nailed it. It was actually right here. See that when I ended in this level, shifted up 2, we get nothing. And that's because level is not 64 bits. Let's do a 74-bit. All right, let's see that again. And actually, I think this needs to be level plus 1 to give it the correct traversal item number thing. Okay, we got flag number starting out 3, and it. Nope, it broke again. What the hell? Oh, no way. It's not that, it's this. Oh, you think it's the AND operator? Maybe it is. Let's see. Flag num. Yeah, you're right. Why is that? That doesn't make any sense. The AND operator, shouldn't that just be operating off of flag num? Okay, let's see this. Let's see this value actually. Let's make it an auto. Right, level plus 1. Oh, and. Oh, it's or. Right? Oh, man, that's definitely a head slapper right there. Thanks, J2. Man, one of those days. Thanks, man. 2LL, that's long. I probably shouldn't even need that anymore, huh? Let's see what happens if I just do this. Should be like that. It's fine now. What's up, Mad Mortigan? Martigon? Mad Martigon. Man, beautiful, beautiful, blood. Yes, fail fish, head slapper. Okay, this time, flag number is 3. And in the level, yay, we finally got the level proper. Okay, good, and then flag number, shifted up 32, that should still be fine, yay. Good there, great. Run this again, this should be the same area, 840. This time the direction should be opposite. Good, we got 1. Flag number ended, yep. Flag number for this one is 5, which is 1 and 0, 1, yep. Okay, this appears to be working now. Oh, good question. How long did it take to render that? World. Num flags, shift them down. Num is now 1-1-1-1-1-1-1. Oh my god, oh, I messed it up again. Oh. Because, putting only a direction in the bottom four bits makes it so you can only have one direction once again. Oh, so I guess I need to have four different sets of four bits to specify all four directions. Right? So if I have four different directions and I want to specify that all four are open, you can turn on the first bit, the second bit, the third bit, the fourth bit. No. It only needs four bits for that. Okay. Anyways, I need to set this bit right here. It's the direction. I need to turn the direction into an actual bit. So it's one shifted up. The direction D plus two. Yeah, J2. Thanks, man. Yeah. I don't know what's up with my brain today and bit shifting. It's like bit shifting is this totally foreign concept. This is a very important one to check because direction or area 840 has both of these different gates. So level plus one shifted up two, right? So that would give me one. Actually, this might need to be shifted up three because we're using a fourth or three shifted up. The maximum direction is three, which is east. Three shifted up one. It's gonna become four. So yeah, we need five bits actually to specify all. Why do we need five bits? Doesn't make sense. The first one is either zero or one. The next one, zero or one. The next one, zero or one. The next one, zero or one. But that fourth one is a fourth. Yeah. If you have four directions, you actually need five bits in order to represent that one of them could be zero. So yeah, it is five bits, and this should be a shifted up three. The next thing should be shifted down three. Oh, it's censoring? It's censoring now? Before it wasn't censoring. Weird. Yeah, your brain, yeah, nice, J2. Yeah, my brain is not working that way, especially today. Okay, so let's make sure this parses correctly on the other end as well. So this should be one shifted up the direction. Yeah. Okay. Go back to world. Okay, this time it should do... Here's where we do key condition is num shifted down three. That's an easy part. Okay, so I think the direction. Or, well, oh no, we only need to check one direction. Oh, that's right. So, not numDir equals D, but if num and one shifted up the direction that we're currently on. So direction 0 would be 1. Yeah, num and 1, num and 3, num and 4. I think that's okay. All right, let's run it. Hope this works this time. Make it simple for now. Use four variables. I could have just done flag one or whatever. But I really want everything to be packed into these 64 bits. Okay, here we are at this technically difficult area to pack in or whatever. We've got flag number this time, starting off with one shifted up the direction plus two, which would turn out to be three. So one shifted up three. Yeah, now we've got four. Yeah, 4 bits, and we've got the top bit set this time. Awesome. Yes, so you do need whatever. I don't know why this doesn't. Oh, four. Oh. We might not even need this three here, but oh well. So flag number. Wait, what happened here? Good, now we've got that other bit right above. Yeah, so it is three. Cool. When you're tired of everything, you make a ray tracer. Oh, only when unpacking. Right. Yeah, I could do that with the flag numbers. I could say flag number one is south, flag number two is west and all that, but I think this is clear enough as it is, or as clear as it's going to be. So that flag, it's setting 1 1 0 0 0. This next time it sets a flag for that same area, it does flag number this time of 1 0. And then flag number, adding in the level. It didn't work. Whoa, what's up with this? Weird, so weird. There. Okay, yeah, added in the flag number. No, oh, that's wrong. Okay. I parsed the flag numbers wrong. Or the actual level numbers. This should be flag number or equals one. Shift it up. Level plus three or four. Three. Yeah, so if level is zero, we're shifting up three. No, I think it should be four. Yeah, plus three plus one or four. Okay. Yeah, I'm just packing in the level with the red with directions. So an area could there's so there's 32 bits, and an area could have the traverse. There's two things to put into each direction, and that is. Or there's one thing. There's just the traversal item number. There's eight traversal items. There's four directions, and I want to be able to specify multiple of those. So I'm blocking off 8 bits for the traversal items and 4 bits for the four different or 5 bits. I don't know. Four. Just four. 4 bits for the directions. So there's 12 total bits. I'm just trying to get it all straight. I think that's right. One shifted up level plus four. Yeah. So flag number starting off, the fourth bid is set, which is east. The level, we've got levels, level one. Yeah, so level one, yeah, that's right. Okay, so level one is this fifth bit or sixth bit. Level zero would have been the fourth bit or fifth bit right here. So that's good. Then we set the flag. Okay, and let's see that again from that other direction. Flag number is 10, which is the west, yeah, and then it's area number five or level number four, whatever. So we got one, these four bits. This is level one, two, three, four, five. Yay! Hooray! Did I update the unpacking? What you mean? That's like porn to me. Right, here we are parsing that direction. So we've got, so that total, the total flags for that came out to be this num. Where is this num shifted down 32? Where to go? Yeah, all right. So, oh, did I do it wrong? Yeah. Damn it, this should have had both those directions packed in. What's up, MC? So, J2, what were you saying about it being incorrect? Looks like I did do something wrong here. It should have had two different directions for this area. Oh. Going to be ending up spending in a whole 2 hour stream just on this, packing in 12 bits. Yeah, sorry. What did I do? What did I do wrong here? Flag num. OR equals, shift it up, set flag ORs it. Okay, let me, I could do it by setting in. Thanks, man. I'm gonna try and set it this way by going, gonna set a variable here. So there, we can see what that is when I step in there. So after it sets it the second time, we can see what the heck happened. Because this should have been fine. It's got the direction, it's got the flag numbers. We're only ORing. Let's see what happens here. Here we are, we're at 840. Oh, another thing that should be. Direction is mass compatible value? That's a good question. It should be. Dir is actually just an enum, which is, I guess would technically be an integer. Yeah, this is technically just an integer. So maybe it isn't mass compatible. Maybe that should be unsigned or UN64. But it appears to be coming out to be the right value to start. Right, so the flag number for this one is set. Let's step into this method where it sets the flag. So here on the top 32 bits, we've got 1001. Only one shifted up D. No, that's what this is. This is the opposite direction, though. I've got one shifted up. No, I don't. I want the first direction, though. The first direction to be a one. So I wanted actually to flag that bit. Is that right? Yeah, I want to turn the directions into flags. So zero, I want zero to represent no directions, one to represent west, two to represent north, four, the fourth bit to represent east. Yeah, that's right. Yeah. One shifted up zero. Totally. That's what I want. Okay, let's see what happens the second time it runs this. Flag number one shifted up. Plus the level. I can't tell, but I think that did pack them both correctly in there. Thanks, Arcane. Thank you, man. All right, here we are back again at 840. I just looked at those bits. It was fine. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, yeah, I know. This is definitely the right area. Num turns out to be it's wrong, so wrong. Oh my God. Coordinate is the same? What you mean coordinate is the same? What's up, Teak? Only if it's Pikachu. Oh, man. So you need to check if flag correctly packed a second time. Yeah. Yeah. I just added a little bit there, so hopefully it does pack that second time. Totally. Yeah, I agree. Something's going wrong here, right? Why is it packing? Why is it not getting the value correct after all this? So the first flag number that we want to set is 101000. All right, that gets packed in. And yeah, we've got a correct pack of 101000. Run to the next point at where it's the same area. The next flag we want to pack in is one, a bunch of zeros, then a 10. And stepping into this method, we set the flag, we OR it. Here's what we get. Yeah, see, look at that. It packed correctly. It's got the 10000, it's got the 10, and it's got these other two bits for the two different directions. So this is fine. This is all good for maze point X8. Y four. And we're at mega seed plus 18. This should still be mega seed 8 or plus 18. Yeah, we're plus 18. This is still the same mega seed. Position P. Yeah, we're creating the level. Right, what is flags? See, flags is wrong. Damn. Fags. Set flag is going to be called for all directions. Yeah. Fags like cigarettes, right? Yeah. Oh, sorry guys, the stream just reset. Yeah, J2, I think you're right. What's up, clock? Sorry, the stream's dying like crazy today, but I got about 5 more minutes. Let me show you guys what I'm working on. For anybody that's just, joined the stream, you haven't even seen the game run in a minute. Here's what the game. I'm at this one area. Just chilling today? Cool. So I'm working on gates, right? All I'm working on is just basically the player being able to not be allowed access to certain areas unless they have a certain traversal item. Yeah, Dev Life's going great, man. I love Dev Life. So this particular, oh, you know what? This worked. Oh my God. So I've been trying to debug this thing the whole time, and it did work fine. Check it it just freaking works. Those are supposed to be those bombable pillars over there. And these are supposed to be these kind of pillars over here. This totally worked. Wow, okay, so maybe it did pack them all right, and for some reason it just wasn't showing it. Yeah, I think I was just trying to debug a little bit too hard there. Yeah, the stream uptime since I just started. 24-hour stream, huh? You guys have been trying to get me to do a 24-hour stream. And maybe I will actually do one of those at some point. I don't know. this part? Huh? What? Yeah, I'm dropping frames like crazy today. I don't know what it is. Game show's going crazy. It's just trying to reconnect all the time. Bit better now, yeah. I don't know what's up, man. It's just been one of those days. Like, it's not like, I think it could be my internet. It could be my internet's just messed up today. But yeah, JT, I think it was working that whole time, man. I don't know what's up. I don't know why the code was so... Oh, check this out. I had two of them running at once. Let there be light. I'm still confused though as to why this debug info is coming out wrong, or seems to be coming out wrong. If I disable this breakpoint, I know it's setting those flags correctly. And then I get to this other breakpoint where it's creating the gate. We should get a num value. Oh, it might be this. This breakpoint was on the wrong line. Rip again? Goddamn. Num. Oh, see, it is right. Nice. Okay, it was fine the whole time. It was fine. False rip. We got pizza rip. Dude. Anyways, yeah, so that's going to be it for today's stream. Like, dude, this is going so crazy. I'm sure it's horrible to watch the stream just restarting all the time and stuff. But, yeah, well, Teak, it's already been 2 hours, though. I'm up for my time for today. Yeah, it could have been two instances. Yeah, J2, it could have been that. But yeah, it's working now. It's working fine. So if I run the game, turn off breakpoints, all those gates are now correct. They're on the right sides of the screen. They're the right traversal items. Right, especially this area right up here. These gray ones are supposed to be there, and these brown guys over here are supposed to be there, so. Yeah, that's it for today's stream. Sorry, guys. It's been a crazy stream with the stream going in and out all day. But, yeah, that's it for today. I'm basically just been making these gate items and stuff. So, I'll be working more on that tonight, and I'll be back streaming tomorrow and the next day. But then it's going to be Thanksgiving, so I'll be taking off. So yeah, that's it for today's stream. Sorry about the crazy stream today. But, yeah. Cheers, you guys. We'll see you next time. PC Warrior. Later, guys.